And these are the real women warriors that I've seen in my lifetime in this movement, and in the sovereign movement of BC. And I'm so glad to see them all here with their children. And the song we are going to sing came out of Mount Currie from another woman warrior when the blockade was going on in Mount Currie. Her last name is Pierre, and this is for her women warrior song. And we take it onto ourselves as women warriors that this song is the beginning of the march here, and beginning of everything for you. I noticed as people here that showed up on the Vancouver occupied territory, and this will go down in history, and I know it will. And I'm glad to see that we are all here together as one, and it took over a week for us to become one. Now we are family and we are friends, and this Women Warrior song is dedicated to all the women warriors, because without women, men wouldn't be here. So they're the life givers, and they're the healers, the fighters for their lands and their sacred territory and water and plants, and no mining on all our territories, not just BC. That here we are. Here's the Women's Warrior song. Thank you.
Because it was a powerful message. Oh, wow. Silenced everyone, especially the men.
Thank you.
That's what I wanted.
Denise, say you. Saki, say you. Sky, say you. Simgikyat, Sakiramina, Kankabawisu. My name is Mal Basil. And what we'd like to begin with next is. You must have heard of the United Nations Declaration on the Rights of Indigenous Peoples. There is clauses throughout that declaration that asserts that we must operate with free, prior, and informed consent in terms of dealing with Indigenous peoples, working with Indigenous peoples. Well, free, prior, and informed consent already exists in our culture. It already exists in our protocols. So our next step is to bring up the delegation's representatives and to ask permission even just to be here on this territory and bring our ideologies with us. and how our hosts can accept us being here and operating on their territory, because our hosts have access to their ancestors. They have access to their laws. This land has laws prior to us all coming here. We must live by the law of the land, not just indigenous laws, but even the law of the land, the law that existed here before we all came here. So our next step is a protocol. If we can ask representatives from each delegation to come up and join us, please. And we would like to also ask of Cease Weiss to accept our request to operate here with free prior informed consent. So we have a number of delegations that met in the Indigenous Assembly against mining and pipelines, and coming together as Indigenous peoples united against pipelines and mining, the delegates' representatives are here to represent their broader delegations that they brought here to Coast Salish territory. Unceded and occupied territory of the Coast Salish is going to welcome us.
Chakmahach, 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 Tiamen Tsiaya, Toistana, Kuyen Snas, Siswais Neaman, Chakmahach, Chakmahach, to all the delegates present here today and those that you represent, Voichok, Voichakil. I want to, as part of our protocols, we share songs, so I'm going to share a song. But before I talk about that song, I'm going to acknowledge the people who are stepping forward on behalf of those that they represent. And I want to say that this is shared territory of the Pumatquim, the Tlewatuth, and the Squamish Olkhamea. And even in these times where people think that, you know, what does the term colonization mean? We're still colonized because we're not speaking our language to you today. I still have to translate what I'm saying to you guys, but I don't have to translate to the people standing up here because they understand, because that is a language that is older than this city, older than this province, and almost as old as this land that we speak on, Voichuk. The song I'm going to share to welcome you all and to bless your time here, Sumquo, it's like a blanket to wrap around you for your time here. The song I'm going to share is a song that's come to be known as our Coast Salish anthem, because it's a song that was gifted from the George family to be shared with all of our people when doing protocol, doing important sacred work. And the work I feel that you're doing is the most sacred work, because it is protecting the land, the water, the sky, everything. So I feel that the work that these people do are on the front lines. We must stop the destruction of our earth and our waters. All of that, the air that we breathe is all affected. We don't notice it so much today because we're even in a concrete jungle like this. We're only not even a mile from the shoreline, where the air sweeps away the pollution. So these people live in a place, in places where that pollution doesn't go away, and it goes into the blood of their children. So that's going back into their bloodline, and it's altering, making us all genetically modified organisms. And that's not our stand as Indigenous people. We are of the land and the water and the sky, and we will be. We have been for time immemorial. We'll be here. We'll be the last ones walking on earth. That's what I believe. Chief Jan George Slolam. It's a prayer song. It's also a paddle song. The song was brought out to all Coast Salish people during Gadawas. It's again another time when we took a chance as Indigenous people and put the big canoes back in the water with our young people. It saved our language, it's saving our culture. 25 years ago when it started, there were 9 canoes, and now there are probably about 120 canoes going out in the water every year. So that's what peaceful protest is about. That's about creating change, facilitating change through dialogue and through direct action that doesn't result in death. It results in continuation of living
in a culturally dignified way, for which
Yeah.
Sinishaya, please. And Sinishaya to the Coast Salish, the ancestors here watching over us all, being with us today. Thank you for the welcome and for understanding that as an Indigenous assembly here, consisting of the Shishrepmek, of the Nklakakmek, of the Mayan, the Tsaykas, the Wet'suwet'en, Tsimshian, the Tsaykotin, and Tsaywanika, Oyarika, Purikuta, and Nakazgli. We thank you for accepting our gifts and asking with free prior informed consent to operate and offering us the talking stick. While we're here, we're participating in your protection of your own ideologies here in this land by bringing our own here and sharing what we have. As many, many others of our Indigenous Assembly. And we'd like to start and make a few announcements that we're going to be converging on this end, and we are marching today to Pan Pacific, and we are marching from this end and this aisle, and we will follow the lead banner, and we make a few stops along the way. Prior to this, Takaya Blaney is going to read an announcement, and before we ask Takaya to read this announcement, we would like to offer a prayer for Ashley. And a moment of silence. We can begin with that. Sayurikai, Uwisa Mogilaha, Great Creator. Seneca Yah Urikai, Ats Tabi Hanzu. Uwisa Mogilaha. We thank you for this beautiful day. We ask that you bless the spirits of all the people here today. Bless this land, the ancestors, the land keepers. We ask that you bless the spirit of Ashley and that she is met with really, really good energy and prayers for her family. We also pray for the safety for the families and the people here today and all those who are occupying Vancouver and all those who are decolonizing Coast Salish territories. We ask that you continue to bless us all. We ask for prayers and good energy for all the world movements that are looking to decolonize. We ask that you continue to help us to build us on our strengths. All my relations. Hey. It's Takaya Blaney.
The plans of Christy Clark and the BC government to push mining and pipeline developments to unceded Indigenous territories will fail. We are opposing these plans and will be protesting the provincial and federal government for continually violating inherent Aboriginal rights and title. The BC government also hopes to proceed with a plan of signing a 10 non-treaty agreement to create economic certainty for corporations. But Clark's government has no jurisdiction to pursue her economic agenda without free, prior, and informed consent because we, grassroots Indigenous people, legally, politically, spiritually, culturally, and inherently maintain Aboriginal title and jurisdiction over our territories. Small number of Indigenous people benefiting from industrial developments. The meager share of profits and few jobs that are promised by corporations and government are not worth devastating impact on our water, salmon, food base, spiritual sites, cultural well-being, and traditional livelihoods, children, and future generations. Indigenous people are disproportionately impacted by industrial development from high rates of toxic waste, pollution, ill health in our communities, as well as systemic poverty through the encroachment of destruction of our territories. For this reason, we reject the short-term interests of profit that motivates those mining and pipeline developments that are trespassing on our unceded indigenous lands. We are indigenous peoples united, stopping pipelines and mining. Yeah! Thank you.
What a cool little bird. One beard.
We'd like to also thank other members of our delegations that have arrived here as well. So we listed a few of them off. There was also Takaya, who is also from the Tsleil-Waututh Nation. And Clawquit. And Statliam. So there are many others. There are other indigenous societies throughout the globe that are looking to decolonize. And we really, really must support decolonization movements. And we need to see a reciprocal support for Occupy movements, as well as Arab Spring, as well as these movements that decolonize our indigenous nations' territories.
Thank you. We'd like to talk briefly about this nation that has been with us here in Vancouver, also claiming to the mining companies, why are they invading their sacred territories? They've been now resistant more than 500 years, and the government in Mexico has given away the unceded territories. Now there's 38 mining concessions to First Majestic and other Canadian and U.S. mining corporations. The Wirarica Nation, they are the wardens of the sacred place Wirikuta, which is for many of the indigenous nations in Mexico, the place where the culture was originated. It is a place in a very fragile land, in the desert, in the middle of desertic land. So already there are mining companies operating in there, and they have literally exhausted the water sources that are just go underground. There is no rivers on surface. They have already polluted. We know how is it. So Wirarikas has been here with us a couple of times. There's been many people here that have shown their support to them, and they are willing to come again because their will is to form this alliance with you, with the indigenous people of the north, and then the indigenous people in the south against these governments that are invading their territories, that I want to destroy their sacred lands, and ultimately they want to eliminate the culture. So we are here just ourselves voicing for them. But the people will come, and here we are forming this group, which is called Wirikuta Vancouver Alliance. And we will be providing more information, and we ask you just to be aware on tune on this. Thank you very much. Pam Pariux in Wirarica.
Hi, so we'll be starting our march soon, and this here is our lead banner, and they'll be going over to the side, and everyone who's going to be rallying with us today, please follow them. I'm Kukshtem.
Stand up for a fight. So you better get up, stand up in the morning, give it up. right. Indigenous Assembly, united against mining and pipelines. Occupy Vancouver. We're on the move. Get up, stand up. Get up, stand up. Mother Earth is under attack. What you gonna do? Mother Earth is under attack. What you gonna do? Stand up, fight back.
Stand up, fight back. Stand up, fight back.
Stand up, fight back.
Stand up, fight back.
Stand up, fight back.
Stand up, fight back.
Stand up, fight back.
Stand up, fight back.
Stand up, fight back.
Stand up, fight back.
Stand up, fight back.
Stand up, fight back.
Stand up, fight back.
What are we fighting for? Human rights. What are we fighting for? Indigenous rights. What are we fighting for?
Human rights.
What are we fighting for?
Indigenous rights.
What are we fighting for?
Human rights.
What are we fighting for? Indigenous rights. What are we fighting for? Human rights. What are we fighting for?
Indigenous rights.
What are we fighting for?
Human rights.
What are we fighting for?
Indigenous rights.
You know what? Don't mind me, Christy Fly. Indigenous title around these parts.
Indigenous title around these parts.
You know what? No mining, Christy Clark.
You want no mining, Christy Clark.
Indigenous title around these parts.
Indigenous title around these parts.
You know what? No mining, Christy Clark.
You want no mining, Christy Clark.
Indigenous title around these parts.
Indigenous title around these parts.
You know what? No mining, Christy Clark. Indigenous title around these parts.
Indigenous title around these parts.
You don't want no mining, Christy Clark.
You want no mining, Christy Clark.
Indigenous title around these parts.
Indigenous title around these parts.
You don't want no mining, Christy Clark.
You want no mining, Christy Clark.
Indigenous title around these parts.
Indigenous title around these parts.
What are we fighting for?
Human rights.
What are we fighting for?
Indigenous rights.
What are we fighting for?
Human rights!
What are we fighting for?
Indigenous rights!
United we stand, divided we fall.
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 Stand and fight. Today's the day, right now. It's not tomorrow, it's now, right now.
El pueblo unido jamás será vencido. El pueblo unido jamás será vencido.
El pueblo unido jamás será vencido. El pueblo unido jamás será vencido.
El pueblo unido jamás será vencido.
El pueblo unido jamás será vencido.
El pueblo unido jamás será vencido.
El pueblo unido jamás será vencido.
The people united will never be defeated.
The people united will never be defeated.
The people united will never be defeated. El pueblo unido jamás será vencido.
El pueblo unido jamás será vencido.
Yeah!
Attack!
streets!
Our streets!
Our streets!
Our streets!
Our streets!
Whose streets?
Our land!
Whose land?
Our streets!
Whose land?
Our land!
Whose land?
Our land!
Whose land?
Our land!
Whose streets?
Our
streets!
Whose streets?
Whose land?
Our land!
Whose streets?
Whose streets?
Whose streets?
Whose streets?
Who has the last say?
People have the last say.
Who has the last say?
People have the last say.
Who has the last say?
People have the last say.
Who has the last say?
People have the last say.
Christy Clark?
Hell no.
Who has the last say?
People have the last say.
Who has the last say?
People have the last say.
Christy Clark?
Hell no.
The mining companies?
Hell no.
Chief and council?
Hell no.
The people have the last say.
The people have the last say.
Who has the last say?
The people have the last say.
Christy Clark?
Hell no.
Chief and council?
Hell no.
The mining companies?
Hell no.
Who has the last say?
The people have the last say.
Who has the last say?
The people have the last say.
Christy Clark?
Hell no.
Chief and council?
Hell no.
Mining companies?
Hell no.
Who has the last say?
The people have the last say.
Who has the last say?
The people have the last say.
Christy Clark?
Hell no.
Chief and council?
Hell no.
Mining companies?
Hell no.
Who has the last say?
The people have the last say.
The 99%.
We are the 99%.
We are the 99%.
We are the 99%.
Who is the 99%?
We are the 99%.
Who is the 99%?
We are the 99%.
We are the 99%. Who is the 99%?
We are the 99%.
We are the 99%.
We are the 99%.
Protect our children, fight for the land.
Protect our children, fight for the land.
Let's stand together, hand in hand. Protect our children, fight for the land.
Protect our children, fight for the land.
Let's stand together, hand in hand.
Stand together, hand in hand.
Protect our children, fight for the land.
Protect our children, fight for the land.
Let's stand together, hand in hand.
Stand together, hand in hand.
We don't want no mining, Christy Clark.
We don't want no mining, Christy Clark.
Indigenous title around these parts.
We don't want no mining,
Christy
Clark.
Indigenous title around these parts.
Indigenous title around these parts.
What are we fighting for?
Human rights.
What are we fighting for?
Indigenous rights.
What are we fighting for?
Human rights.
What are we fighting for?
Indigenous rights.
Who has the last say?
People have the last say.
Who has the last say?
People have the last say.
Christy Clark?
Hell no.
The mining companies?
Hell no.
Chief and council?
Hell no.
Who has the last say?
People have the last say.
The people have the last say.
People have the last say.
The people have the last say.
People have the last say.
The people have spoken.
Woo! to make this one of our first stops. 595 is on Burrard. Here is Thompson Creek Metals. I'd like to introduce to you Ken Sam from the Nakazli. Hadi, Duato. Okay. Thompson Creek is starting the Mount Milligan mine in our territories. It is our territory. Christie Clark, their former premier made a deal, and the bureaucrats, the companies recognize another First Nation as owners of the land, where we are the owners of the land. We've occupied those lands for generations. This is not right. These people are promised jobs, living better lives due to this mine. And that is not happening to them. They are operating right now. They knocked down trees to get to the mine site. Those trees, those logs are still piled up right now in their haste. It's waste. It's just total waste that they leave on the site. And in their haste to extract that mine, these are the way this company is operating. And Christie Clark, RCMP, federal and provincial governments are supporting this United States company. It's not even a Canadian company that they're supporting and protecting. We tried to stop them. We tried to slow them down. We succeeded a bit last year. And now it's full speed ahead. They put an injunction against us, and they've got many, many people from all over the country developing this mine and the infrastructure. There's hardly any of our people over there benefiting. All the benefits, the major benefits, is going to United States shareholders and people from all over, probably all over the world, are coming over to work in our lands, these skilled people. And we're sitting back here and we watch most of the traffic go by, and we're sitting on the wayside again. I don't know how many times we have to do that. Somebody has to say no. Gee, that's why I'm here.
Nikaya Kentam from the Nakazli. We'd also like to introduce Marika Swan from the Clackwit peoples. She's going to speak to Imperial Metals.
My name is Marika Swan. My native name is Amanusapsu. I come from the Colloquian Nation on the west coast of Vancouver Island. And we're outside Imperial Metals, and Imperial Metals is doing exploratory drilling in our territory. We have an abandoned old gold mine that they are interested in investigating and seeing how much gold they can get out of it. They're also doing exploratory drilling in Ahauset, which is the community just north of us. And this is a huge concern for us, because these mines don't just affect individual territories. This will leach into our waters, and all of these mines that they're planning to approve are going to leach into everybody's territories eventually. We need to stop this mining. I went with a delegation of our nation to go up into the where they had the proposed gold mine to see what they were doing and to ask them to leave, because they are not asking the consent of our people. They are not consulting in the proper way that they should be. We are the proper owners of our land. We decide what happens, not the mining companies, not the government. We know what's best for our rivers and our salmon and seven generations into the future. We need to stop thinking paycheck to paycheck, and we need to start thinking about generations and generations and generations of our children. So I have a statement from our chief and council. On behalf of Colloquia Chief and Council, we do not support Imperium Metals activities at the Fandora site in Tranquil Inlet that is within Colloquia traditional territories. We do not support Imperium Metals' process of telling us how environmentally sound their work plan will be. The Colloquia leadership demands that Imperium Metals cease all activities, or we will be forced to take direct action or other legal means to assert our title and rights. We also demand that Imperium Metals release all present and future documentation that your company has on the Fandora gold mine. In order for our Colloquia to make an informed decision and an accurate environmental assessment, we demand that Imperium Metals finance this review by a consultant of our own selection. We would like to remind Imperium Metals or any mining company that Colloquia people will not sit by and allow for the destruction of our lands and resources. And if required, we, along with our supporters, will fill up the prison system like we did in the early 90s when over 900 people were arrested for the protection of our Colloquia Chief's territories. And for any further information about the position of the Colloquia Band Council, you can talk to Terry Dorward, who is a Colloquia Councillor at 250-726-3736. Go! Thank you, Coast Salish people, for allowing us to bring our message to your territories.
Thank you, Marika Swan from the Colloquia. We're going to move on. We got to go to Taseko. On we go.
Indigenous title around these parts. indigenous title around these parts.
We don't want no mining, Christy Clark.
We don't want no mining, Christy Clark.
Indigenous title around these parts.
Indigenous title around these parts.
We don't want no mining, Christy Clark.
We don't want no mining, Christy Clark.
Indigenous title around these parts.
Indigenous title around these parts.
We don't want no mining, Christy Clark.
We don't want no mining, Christy Clark.
Indigenous title around these parts.
Indigenous title around these parts.
Who has the last say?
People have the last say.
Who has the last say?
People have the last say.
Christy Clark?
Hell no.
The mining companies?
Hell no.
Chief and council?
Hell no.
Who has the last say?
People have the last say.
Who has the last say?
People have the last say.
The mining companies?
Hell no.
Chief and council?
Hell no.
Christy Clark?
Hell no.
Who is that anyway?
Okay, let's check out the Women's Warrior song, folks. Anybody with a drum, but everybody with their voices.
Her mom is the one with the white hood right behind her. See her?
Oh,
the white hood and a burgundy jacket. Yeah.
Okay.
And her dad is the one with the glasses. So her dad is here too. She's a missing little girl.
Are you okay?
Yeah, okay. Is an ally of our tribe.
Hundreds and hundreds of years ago, our tribe went to battle with Tsilhqot'in, but we find ourselves more and more being forced
down with the speakers,
closer
okay?
and closer to battle. These mining companies, logging companies, anything that comes in to destroy our water and our Mother Earth. The following is a statement from the Tsilhqot'in in June 2010. The Tsilhqot'in Nation has never ceded or surrendered our rights or title to our land, water, or way of life, including our future generations. We are gratefully still able to drink from our streams, rivers, lakes, alongside the wildlife. It is our duty and responsibility to protect these headwaters, wildlife, plants, including the forests and lands that sustain us and have done so since time immemorial. We still live with respect to our Mother Earth, annually gathering our medicines, berries, hunting and fishing, and passing on these traditional practices to our children, youth, and share with others on our land. Our people have always protected these lands and wild salmon, as in the War of 1864 when our war leaders stopped the road coming in from Butte Inlet, the southwest side of the Tsilhqot'in territory. Our people knew back then that if they allowed the invasion for gold, it would destroy our wild salmon along with our way of life. And again, today we are faced with the same threat.
Hello, my name is Takai Blaney. I'm 10 years old and I'm from Tsilhqot'in Nation. I'm speaking here on because people of Canada need to know about Canada, not just about how the companies see Canada and tell it to the citizens, about how we Indigenous people see Canada. And they need them to know that it's not just a big place to just develop and pollute, it's where our ancestors have lived and it's our territory, and we won't stand for it being developed. One of the reasons I'm speaking here is because of Tsilhqot'in. And my nation, Tsilhqot'in, is going through treaty right now. And when the treaty first came in, the people said no, no. And they kept voting, and they kept bothering them, and they kept saying no. And when they put the residential schools in, the culture was lost. And it wasn't lost forever, but it was just, they lost enough so the current generations do not understand the value of the traditions. And so now they're starting to say yes to things. So if they're listening right now. So I need people to listen that we can't just keep trading with developments coming through and asking Indigenous people to trade their land. We can't trade it. It's not ours to give away, so. The song that I was singing back at the art gallery was called Earth Revolution, and it's about how we, the people, can stand up to these corporations, and it's also about how children can stand up to these corporations. Because one day we're going to have to, because one day the corporations will have to pass down the planet to the children, because they will be inheriting it. And what will the children inherit? A big polluted earth with
shame.
Is that what we're going to be inheriting?
No!
So we need to really change how they are doing these things right now. So our children, so the children can of the future can live in the earth and share the same experiences as just, you know, seeing forest as we do today. So, thank you.
Thank you, Takaya. Thank you. Let's move on.
We say shut it down, pocket lunch. Pocket lunch. And I say Tarzan. You say shut it down, Tarzan. Tarzan. Yeah.
Show some courtesy, Christy Clark. Knock before you enter. You're just a guest. And you're not welcome right away. The people have spoken. Who has the last say?
Christy Clark!
Indigenous title around this park!
We don't want no mining, Christy Clark!